Yesterday, the most powerful people in Indonesia were just around the corner from me. They're missing out on all the tasty street food you can find in Menteng. Follow me as I review the Menteng presidential street food and familiarize you with the hidden gems of central Jakarta.
Welcome back to the Base Indonesian Show. Today, we're heading to this one magical place called KPU, where presidential candidates pack entire streets with their supporters in an effort to cause as much traffic jam as possible so people will be inconvenient. What we want to do today, we don't want to focus on the presidential candidates. No, no, no. We are going to review some of the apa ya bahasanya? Starling ya? Starling itu bahasa Inggrisnya apa ya?
Starbucks keliling,
which means wandering Starbucks, aka moving coffee shops around the area. There's gonna be plenty of them once we get there. As you can see, the chaos is already unfolding at the boulevard, and we're heading straight to the frying pan. Well, es goyang, which means shaking ice. That's pretty much a rough translation. I don't really understand what I call es goyang. But this thing's pretty much just like your bog average popsicle that you would get on normal Indonesian street markets. Ice in the water, so the flavor of the chocolate, you don't really get to taste it that much. It's mostly just water and ice and some peanuts. There's a bit of, I don't know what this is, but it doesn't really taste as sweet as chocolate. It seems great though. I mean, it's perfect for a really hot day. If you're looking for something that is cheap, something that is fast, something you can get in the streets, it's pretty much the perfect food for a hot day. Es goyang is cheap. Menteng es goyang is really cheap. Really cold. Perfect for a hot day. So now we're gonna look for our next food. I don't know what it is. It's probably gonna be iced tea. It's probably gonna be a peanut or some siomai or whatever. But let's go find it out. So our next food is gonna be Cilok 58. It's a really great cilok stand here in Cafe. Perfect for nights that you need when you need some heat and shit. This bad boy right here. I never actually eaten cilok before, but this is probably a first time for everything, you know. It tastes kind of like bakso, you know? Meatballs, you know, Indonesian meatballs. It's a bit sticky. Maybe I haven't really gotten the seasoning yet on the cilok. Maybe it's like about. Yeah, it's definitely very sticky, very, it tastes like chewing gum, basically. Very chewy. It's got a very chewy flavor to it. I added a bit of some seasoning here, so it tastes a bit spicy. Oh, yeah. It's very hot. It's perfect for really cold conditions. You know? And you're out here having a so-and-so cold democratic party right here. Party for the people. Party of democracy. And you need something hot to keep yourself warm. But you don't have enough money for a bakso, so we buy Jilok. Totally recommend Jilok 58. Right here in Menteng, KPU. I thought there was like a bit of sour taste on it, but turns out I was wrong, there was no sour taste at all. I accidentally dropped my G-Lock. Damn. I hope I don't make a mess of the place. Really sorry, police officers who are standing behind me. Probably want some G-Lock as well. I don't want to offer them my G-Lock. I don't know, I'm a bit intimidated. Let's go. So I got myself a batagor from one of the stands inside the exhibition taking out here right now. And I honestly can't find a place to eat them without, you know, getting pushed around by people who are passing by shouting random political bullshit. The rain is getting heavier. Music was getting louder, but now it's, well, it's silent. But yeah, now I can enjoy my batagor in peace. You know, eating batagor is so great, especially when you're surrounded by so much people, share the same passion and energy and vigor as you would. But you also know what's great as well. Hot drink in this rainy night. I think we might need to find some hot drinking order. Push that food through because we've been having like really wet food since we started this episode. Let's go find food. Not really food, but I guess, not really food, but I meant drink. I fucked up there. Anyways, for the batagor, I rate 8 out of 10. I haven't been rating for points, but I guess I should start rating at this point. So, for you non-Indonesian viewers, this stall here, this mobile stall, it's called Starbuck Keliling. Which means a wandering Starbucks. Berapa? So today I stand in the middle of the road, in the middle of the rain, just enjoying my cup of hot teh tarik. Oh, that's good. It was so great about Starlings. Especially the starling that we specifically bought at this stand. They can make anything taste great. And it all tastes the same. Like, it tastes great, but it's all the same. That's what's so great about starling. I wish a lot of people would understand the wonders of starling. But I don't think white folks will be able to enjoy this. I mean, it's really unhygienic, I guess. But as a Thai saying goes, the more unhygienic it is, the more tastier it becomes. So I guess the theory could be applied here. Yeah. So I got out of the middle of the road. I realized I was standing like an idiot. But now here I am, enjoying my cup of teh tarik once again. You know, teh tarik is a perfect drink for rainy days. But it's not exactly cold. So, What I mean by rainy days that is not exactly cold is when it rains, but you don't get the air conditioning. You don't get the gust of wind, you don't get the cold. It's just rain, pure rain. And Tetarik is a perfect companion for that weather. Let me take one more sip. Oh, that's so good. That's so refreshing to the stomach. It seems I pretty much like drank this, but I haven't really finished the drink because, you know, the rain keeps on refilling the cup with free water. But yeah, Menteng Starling Teh Tarik, I would rate it 10 out of 10, no cap, for real. Be bussin'. That's what the kids say these days, right? As you can see, there's a bunch of football fans chanting their favorite team. It's green, probably Brazil, but I won't let that distract me. It's not like that distracted me in the first place, because I'm enjoying my companion Teh Tarik right here. Thank you for tuning in today's Based Indonesian Show episode, where we focus on reviewing some Menteng street food. I hope you enjoy this episode. To be honest, I don't even know what I'm doing. I'm just looking for an excuse to eat food and taste them and get out of my office because it's too stressful. And I will see you in the next episode of the Based Indonesian Show. Bye-bye.